And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. The show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the Miami Marlins going up against the Atlanta Braves. First pitch coming your way next. So just about set now, and pitching here today, Ian Anderson. And for some reason, he's not quite as effective here in front of his home crowd, Chris.
Yeah, Boog, and the fans are well aware of that. For him, he's got to just not press and go out there and say, hey, I'm just treating this like any start. Home, on the road, it doesn't matter. My job is to focus on that catcher's mitt, attack hitters, and just try to move through a ball game. So if he can find that kind of focus, doesn't matter where he's pitching because he has good enough stuff to go out there and win a ball game.
Jazz Chisholm stands in now, looks at that one inside.
First pitch, 14.
Left-hand batter waits. And a foul ball. Next offering in the dirt, and it's 2-1. Rip back to the mound, and that got him. Safe at first, and now after the play, we'll check on the right-hander status.
He's been swinging it really well lately. Got a changeup and a pretty good one, too. Outside corner, but he just got extended and put the barrel on it. Showed he has a lot of plate coverage on that swing right there. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Now here is Jesus Sanchez. Kicks and fires. There's a strike. Next offering is in for a strike. One and two now. Next offering misses down and away. Chisholm gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Popped in the air. Left field. Ozuna drifts towards it. One down. As we take a look at Don Mattingly's lineup for the Marlins. And a key factor for this club in that leadoff spot, Jazz Chisholm.
Yeah, definitely someone I always enjoy, you know, when I get a chance to watch him, whether he's hitting a game or even taking swings during batting practice. Man, this guy is always so focused on what he's doing on that task at hand. He's got so much attention to detail that when he steps in the box, his success rate is really high.
Garrett Cooper at the plate now. Looks at one down below the zone. Anderson over to first. Chisholm back in on a dive. And the right-hander deals. That one's in there. And a count 1-1. Pitches in for a strike, and the count is 1-2. Steal. Runner on the goal. Got him swinging. Go to second. Out. out there, and the inning is over.
Trying to make something happen there on offense, but that's the risk you run. Awesome. Strike him out, throw him out, double play to end the inning.
Bottom of the first, pitching in our game today, Sandy Alcantara. What do you have on him, Chris?
Well, he tried to make it through the fifth inning last time out, but the pitch count just got too high. He ended up taking the loss. That's one of those you just have to shake it off, come back out today, and try to throw a gem.
Bottom of the first, and now it's the switch inning second baseman, Ozzie Albies. He has consistently been one of the best in the sport against lefties, and yet the righties give him trouble. You know, you don't want to be labeled as that guy, but the numbers say what they say. The pitch. That's in there. That's through there for a strike. Not even close there. And it's 2-2. Got him. Now one away. So he gets the call and picks up the strikeout looking.
Sometimes with a good hitter at the plate, he'll be the one to get the benefit of the doubt if he lays off on a close pitch like that, but just not right there. Strike zone definitely expanded a little bit with two strikes.
Dansby Swanson stands in. That one's in there, 0-1. One down, base is empty. And that's outside. That's a slider for a strike.
Now, just a cement mixer slider right there. It's a great pitch to hit if you can recognize it early and jump on it.
Next offering is fouled back. And a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. And the throw gets away. Not in time. He's safe. And here is Ronald Acuna Jr. In there, and it's 0-1. No score here, but a runner at third with one down. Next offering is in for a strike.
I understand you want to try to gauge that guy's fastball, but you also have to be aggressive and ready to hit in your zone. Now you're in a tough spot.
The pitch. And a swing and a miss. Two away now.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step up and get the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty big two-out at bat coming up now.
And now it's Matt Olson's turn to hit. In there for strike one. Swanson at third with two away. Next pitch misses way outside.
One ball. Two strike.
Next one is off the plate. And the count is 2-2. And it's fouled away. Rips that one center field. That's a base hit. Run scores.
Well, they strike first as he gets the job done to bring home the run. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Austin Riley next up for the Braves. Put that 600 slugging into context. The league average usually in the low 400s. And that's in there for strike one.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
First inning and already up to 23 pitches. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's an early 1-0 lead. New inning getting started, and now here's the veteran DH, Jesus Aguilar.
The designated hitter, Jesus Aguilar.
And the right-hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Fastball, and he gets out of the way. The wind of the pitch. Falling behind 2-1. The wind of the pitch.
Three ball, one strike.
That one fouled off. And a swing and a miss. Leadoff man retired here in the second. Jorge Soler up at the plate.
Jorge Soler.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. Clyde Washington with home plate duties in this one.
A little bit of a low zone boot from Clyde. Nothing crazy, though. Pitchers that work consistently down around the knees and are able to command their off-speed stuff tend to have some pretty good success with him back there behind the plate.
Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Got him. Two gone after the strikeout.
Batting sixth, the third baseman, Brian Anderson.
And up next for Miami, Brian Anderson. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. And the righty deals. Good eye in that spot.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Here's a 1-2. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. And down on strikes he goes. The big righty strikes out the side. Nothing doing for the Marlins. They trail here 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, bottom of the second. Now it's the DH, Alex Dickerson. Alcantara back to work. Ground ball left side and foul ball.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Now the 0-1. Inside corner for a strike. 0-2 now.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Righty to the plate. And now 1-2. And a pitch. And a foul ball. Next offering is foul back.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
Oh, that's a really good pass of the ball right there. Just a little bit too quick. He's got to find a way. Just let it travel a hair more.
On the ground, and that's just foul. Swing, and that's ripped towards right center. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Safe at second with a leadoff double.
All over that one right there. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. Put a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all.
Adam Duvall at the plate.
That is seven. The right fielder.
Meanwhile, this pitch gets away. He beats the throw, and they don't get an out on the play. Next offering is in for a strike.
If he doesn't get a knock right here, that pitch he just took is going to eat at him for a while. You might not see another pitch like that from a top-level guy like this.
In there at the knees, and a count 1-2. And now it's even up.
Still just the second batter of the inning, and on the mound he's already thrown 13 pitches. They got him working hard out there.
Down to the dirt, swing and a miss, and it beats him for the first out after the drop third strike. And now it's Travis d'Arnaud with the play.
See,
First pitch, not close. Out to short. Over to Cooper. Runner scores, though. That's a little insurance, and the lead is two. Here's Marcelo Zuna. Hit hard on the ground to short. Out with room to spare, and that's the inning. We played two full. It's the Braves two and the Marlins nothing. And welcome back. On to the third inning. Abisail Garcia up to the plate. For the Marlins, the right fielder. Anderson back to work. And there's the strike. Here comes a pitch. That misses off the outside edge. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. The 1-2. And a ball evens the count. And down on strikes. Leadoff hitter gone in the third.
Well, right now he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. I mean, doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
And the 1-0. Inside just missed. That misses the zone, and that's ball three.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if he'll walk you.
Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. And there's the strike. The 3-1. That one lifted to left. Ozuna on the move. He's got it. And there's two down.
Batting none. The catcher,
Jacob Stallings now. He is at the top of the game in terms of defense at the catching spot. And first offering is fouled off.
It's so impressive because these guys have to do so much study and preparation for their pitchers, for opposing hitters, and really their number one job is to guide that staff through a ball game. And so when you also can turn it up offensively and be a force there, that is a win-win, every manager's dream.
Pitch misses, and it's 2-1. That one in for a strike, 2-2. Two outs. Fought off foul. The wind of the pitch. And another ball. Three, two on the way. And there's ball four. Next to hit, Jazz Chisholm. reached on an infield single his first time. And there's a foul ball. At the belt and fires. Stallings off of first with two away. Next offering way off the plate.
One and two.
Next one just misses. Two and two.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch on the outside corner.
He's got it, and that'll end the inning. We move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Braves 2 and the Marlins nothing. As we go to the last of the third. Now at the plate, Ozzie Albies. And a pitch. Fastball in the corner at the knees, and it's a strike. Kicks and deals. Fouled off left side. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And there's one down. So digging in, Dansby Swanson. Swanson having more success against left-handed pitching this season, as might be expected. First pitch, and he just misses. Next one is off the play, and it's 2-0. Next offering upstairs. In for a strike, now 3-1. Foul ball. The pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
And now it's Ronald Acuña Jr. In there, and it's 0-1.
There it was, a high velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good stuff. Pitch inside the zone and trust it.
Oh, one down. And that one fouled off. Swings and misses, and two away now.
Well, we see it a lot more these days than we ever did when I played, but a slider in the 90s still catches your attention, even if you're sitting on the pitch. Good luck recognizing that tight spin and adjusting to the late break.
Matt Olson up to the plate. In there for strike one. Here's your one.
And at bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be. You just got to hope that you can make contact.
Next one off the plate inside, and it's 1-2. One, two now. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Inning over. Braves strand one. They're up 2-0. Welcome back. Stepping in, Jesus Sanchez.
Leading off for Miami, the center fielder, number 7, Jesus Sanchez.
The pitch. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes the grab, one away. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Singy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Garrett Cooper, the next up for the Marlins. His first at bat was a strikeout. Next pitch downstairs, and that's ball one. On the ground to the left, and it goes just foul. Righty delivers. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss. The 1-2. And foul ball. And a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And now it's Jesus Aguilar.
Designated hitter, Jesus Aguilar.
First offering misses the mark.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
That misses the zone, and that's ball two. The wind to kick the 2-0.
Ball. 3-0 the count.
And a four-pitch walk.
The batter.
And at the plate for Miami, Jorge Soler. That one's in there, 0-1.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Next offering is fouled back. And he deals. Stays alive. Next offering is downstairs. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And fouled off. The 1-2. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. The 1-2. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. The 1-2. Ripped to third. They take the force out. Out number three. One left for Miami, and they're down 2-0.
I don't wear a cape or apron, so I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Do you think?
Back here in Atlanta, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Austin Riley. The wind to kick the pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
One ball, no strike.
Kicks and fires. Late that time, and it's strike two.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Swing and a liner foul off to the right. The 1-2. Swing and a pop-up. Cooper should have this one. Makes the grab, one down. Here's Dickerson now. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Left-hand hitter waits. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's got his second double of the game.
He has had such a good day today. I don't think he's going to want to leave when it's over.
Couple of doubles today for the DH. One down. Now in for the Braves, Adam Duvall.
The right fielder, Adam Duvall.
In there, and it's 0-1. Dickerson, the runner at second with one away. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. That one misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Foul ball there. And here it comes. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Now, Boog, it becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging it or if you want to give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him, and you're just hoping that somehow, some way, it'll click and he can get out of this as quickly as possible.
And now it's going to be Travis Darno. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runner at second, two down. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, I know they've gotten out to an early lead, but you don't want to take these opportunities for granted. With two outs, still lock in with a quality at bat, drive in that run. You may not have another guy in scoring position the rest of this ballgame.
Next pitch is outside.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
Fouled off. He was late. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Man on second, two down. Now fly ball to right center. Garcia under it. Brings it in for the third out. One left for Atlanta as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Back at Truist Park, ready now for the fifth inning. Here's the third baseman, Brian Anderson. The pitch. And there's a strike. Way upstairs. And the count even, 1-1. The pitch. Slow roller to first. Olson takes it to the bag. And a quick out, number one.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Abisail Garcia. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Oh, and one now. And ball one.
1-1.
That one missed. Swing and he breaks his bat. Throw on to Olson, and the first two set down to the top of the fifth.
Got to feel pretty good for the pitcher. Absolutely sawed him off. Bat explodes. And then he makes an easy play on it. Pretty satisfying if you're out there on the ball.
John Birdie at the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The 1-0. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
One strike.
Slice to right. That's a base hit. Two out, base hit, keeps the inning alive. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Braves 2 and the Marlins nothing. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Marcell Ozuna. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. Pitch misses outside, and that's ball one. Next offering is fouled back. One now. And that one fouled off. And the pitch. That misses the zone. The count now 2-2. Bounce to the left side. Anderson collects. Zips it to first. And that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth. Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. Well, in their win last game, this guy came up with two home runs, obviously trying to keep the roll going here in this one. And that's in there for strike one. And it's fouled away.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Kicks and deals. And there's a ball. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Now at 10 Ks with still a few innings left, so expect him to add on to that total. And, you know, pitchers are looking to have a strikeout per inning. I mean, that's excellent work. The way it looks now, I mean, he's going to have a better rate than that in this one. So really good stuff working on the mound in this one.
Dansby Swanson next up for the Braves. That one's in there, 0-1.
One strike.
The pitch. Misses off the inside. One ball, one strike.
Oh, he's got to be pretty proud of this outing so far. Sometimes guys cower coming into a ballpark like this, but he has attacked hitters. Pitching on the road like this is very impressive. This has been a treat to watch.
And 1-2.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some guys.
And a 1-2. Out towards right center field. Garcia settles underneath it. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Down in order go the Braves. But they hold the 2-0 lead. Welcome back. All set for the top of the sixth. And here's the catcher, Jacob Stallings. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. First offering misses the mark.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position. And that's what he does.
Next pitch is outside. Next one misses. Three balls, no strikes.
The hitting's going to come around. He's going to figure it out. But right now, his big asset is the way he plays the game on defense.
Righty to the plate. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it. Jazz Chisholm now. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Stallings aboard here at first with nobody out. In the dirt. And the righty deals. A little bit low. There's a swing and a drive. Way back there. Nobody out. Runner at first. That one pulled foul. Up the middle. It's in and out of his glove. And he'll be safe at first. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Ian Anderson won't go any further. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. At the bullpen is Will Smith.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Jesus Sanchez, the next up for the Marlins. Next offering is down low. 1-0. The lefty to 1-0. Off the mark there. Two balls, no strikes.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
There's a strike.
Everyone here understands just how quickly things could change.
Here comes a pitch. Bounced up the middle. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. He decides to hold on to it, and that loads the bases.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
And now it's Garrett Cooper up to hit. Who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. In there, and it's 0-1.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
And a pitch. And a foul ball.
You need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Darnell puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down.
Well, that's a frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter right there. I mean, that pitch was right down the middle. I think he got a little too excited, came out of his mechanics, and instead of driving that ball somewhere, he popped it up. Unfortunate for him.
And next is the designated hitter, Jesus Aguilar.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
And a pitch. And the 1-0 misses low.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count, base is loaded. You don't want to fall to a three ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here. You know, he can move the ball around, add and subtract, get some weak contact at times. So you don't worry as much about him in this situation. Very capable of getting a ground ball and getting out of this little jam.
At the belt and fires. Lifted in the air, right center field. Duvall, long run into the gap. Makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. A big run scores on the sac fly. It's 2-1.
Well, that's a quality at bat right there. You know the situation. You need something in the air and deep enough, and that's exactly what he did. Good pass to the baseball.
Now here's Darren O'Day to take over for the Braves. Right-hander who throws from the side, really almost down under. So first and second with two outs. Jorge Soler getting ready to hit.
Oh, look out here. He's going to come up ready to swing in this situation.
First offering misses badly for ball one. Two on, two outs. Good eye right there. Two outs. Popped up to the left. Into foul ground. Riley under this one. He's got it. And that'll end the inning. Part of the order, 3-4-5 coming up. It's the Braves 2 and the Marlins 1. Well, we go bottom six. Here's Acuna now. Pretty amazing athlete this guy is. Power and speed, quite a threat. I mean, you're talking about someone that could steal your bag and go deep. Bo Jackson, anyone? And the 0-1. He swings and fouls one off. The 0-2. And that one hammered way back there. And out of here. His 13th home run of the season. And they tack on to their lead. It's 3-1.
Sinker can be a pretty tough pitch because of the late life and movement, but somehow he got the barrel to that pitch, stayed through it. Really nice job of staying on the backside until it was time to transfer that weight, and a really nice home run.
And now Matt Olson up to hit.
Now batting, first base.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. Matt Olson goes deep. His 9th homer of the year. It's 4-1.
Back-to-back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, Boog. I mean, this is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in a lineup feeding off each other, and the collective confidence just continues to grow.
Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. Sandy Alcantara won't go any further. It's a 3-run game, and we'll be back to tell you about the new arm in a minute. New pitcher for the Marlins, James Hoyt. It's his job to keep his team in the game. Here's Austin Riley.
Now batting, the third baseman.
In there for strike one. Next offering down in the dirt. Next one is off the plate, and it's 2-1. Here's the 2-2. Got him looking. One gone here.
Oh, this guy's been pretty much a non-factor so far this weekend. Very little in the way of impactful at-bats and quality at-bats, and let alone contact. That's the sixth time they've set him down on strikes in the series. So no doubt, frustration mounting and very high right now.
Now it's Alex Dickerson. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And the 1-0. Swing and a miss. Ugly swing right there. Miami's bullpen with some action. Zach Pop appears to be warming for Don Mattingly. Blyer getting cranked up as well. Still only one out here in the inning. One, two now.
Two balls, two strikes.
Up the middle. Birdie handles the chance to first. And they get the out. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the right fielder, Adam Duvall. Fought off foul. And the next pitch is way outside. Here's a 1-2. Out to short, and that one finds its way through. So he gets on base and keeps it going.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. I know that was a ground ball, but it was absolutely hammered through the infield. That's not one you're excited to get in front of if you're an infielder. You know they used to say, charge it. Crazy.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Travis Darno. And that's in there for strike one. Duvall, the runner at first with two gone. 0-2 as he waves at that one.
Well, you got the hitter already chasing that nasty slider. If you're on the mound, you just want to expand the zone right now. Get a swing and miss and get through this at bat.
Pitch. And that's downstairs and outside. That misses. 2-2. Right-hander deals, swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That ends the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now 4-1. Back here in Atlanta, now the third baseman, Brian Anderson.
Leading off for the Marlins, the third baseman, Brian Anderson.
And he deals. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least one run. Then maybe you get two or three.
Righty delivers. Breaking ball through there for a strike.
Just a really nice slider down and in there. He wants to get the hitter thinking fastball, speed him up, and just subtract some velocity and add a little movement.
And a pitch. Gonna count ball. One and two.
One ball, two strikes.
In the air, right field, pretty well struck. That one back. Hauls it in on the warning track.
It's a really good swing. He just didn't get quite enough of it to beat the wind. It's blowing in from right field right now.
Avisail Garcia, the next to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Next offering misses. One and one. The 1-1. Smash to the left side. Swanson fires over to first. Two up, two down. Here's a speed threat, John Birdie. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, as good as things can be, it can be a tough day at the office, even for the skippers. Seeing the offense just sputter, not able to get anything going.
The 0-1. And a swing and a miss. And the 0-2. Pitch misses there, and that is ball one. O'Day ahead, 1-2, stays alive. Right-handed reliever, and a foul ball. He stays alive. Right-hander kicks, deals. Ground ball, Olsen. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. And the Marlins down quietly, and they trail it 4-1. Wait. Zach Pop comes on now, and he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 56, Zach Pop.
And welcome back. Here's the left fielder, Marcelo Zuna.
The left fielder.
And here it comes. Bottom of the zone and a called strike. And that misses off the outside edge. And a 1-1. That one way outside. And it's 2-1.
Last couple of pitches, breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
That's the third. Over to Cooper, and the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh. Ozzie Albies up to the plate. First offering way inside, almost got him. Next pitch misses, and now 2-0.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up, and that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
Next offering is down low. That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
Right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
At the plate, Dansby Swanson. Albies on the move. Swing and a miss. Bro, and they got him.
Such a quick and fast swing of emotions right there. You get the runner on with the walk, which is great, but then picks a bad pitch to go on and you just erase the free pass that you were issued. I understand you want to be aggressive, you want to try to get in the scoring position, but you just have to be a little smarter there.
Lifted in the air out to left. Soler has this one sized up, pulls it down, and he makes the catch, and that's the third out. Here comes A.J. Minter to the mound. And now, Jacob Stallings.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
The pitch. In for a strike, and it's 0-1. Ground ball to the right side. Steps on first for the out.
The batter, number two,
back to the top of the lineup, Jazz Chisholm, the next up for the Marlins. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. And a couple of quick outs.
the center field.
And now for the Marlins, Jesus Sanchez.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
In there, and it's 0-1. And now the lefty. And another ball. Left-hand batter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Duvall under it. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Miami down in order. And this is still a 4-1 ball game. Back at Truist Park, bottom of the eighth. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Ronald Acuna Jr. Pop back to work. That one is hammered right field. Can't get there. Base hit. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. He hit that ball really well to deep right field right there. Got a pitch to drive and just stayed through it nicely. Didn't quite have the trajectory to clear the fence, but you're always happy with an extra base hit.
So a man aboard here is Matt Olson.
The first baseman, Matt.
In there for strike one. No outs, runner on second. Pitch misses inside, ball one. And it is 2-1. Man at second. That's down and in.
Good slider down and in can be so hard to get on plane with. You're better off taking that pitch.
Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone. A two-run homer, home run number 10 of the year. It's 6-1.
Pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
They hand the ball over to a new arm, Richard Bleier. 32nd appearance.
Well, he's having an excellent season so far. ERA is under 2. A lot of flexibility coming out of the bullpen.
Here's the third baseman, Austin Riley.
Now that the third baseman, Austin.
First offering misses the mark.
1-0.
Next offering is fouled back. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that's the first out.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Next is the designated hitter, Alex Dickerson. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kicks and fires. Got it started a little too early. Strike one. Swing and a ball popped up. Anderson settles underneath it. Squeezes it. Two away.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Adam Duvall next up for the Braves. And that's in there for strike one. Duvall checks his swing. Now it appeal to first. And that's a swing according to umpire Ed Drummond. 0-2 now. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's the inning. Braves pick up two on the long ball. Last chance coming up here for the Marlins. Kenley on here, and a healthy sized lead for him to go to work with. And at the plate for Miami, Garrett Cooper. The wind and the pitch. There's the strike.
Well, they say it's the best pitch in baseball. Strike one. You get ahead on a good hitter as well. Gives you a little bit more confidence to move through the at-bat.
And the 0-1. And a foul ball. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth. Here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jesus Aguilar. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Movement in the Atlanta bullpen. Luke Jackson, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. Matzik, the lefty, warming up as well. And the pitch. And that one missing low. The wind of the pitch.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Righty to the plate. Swings and misses. And that is strike two. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch misses inside, and it's a ball and a strike. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss.
Fooled on that pitch. Got a little anxious. And now in a two-strike count, he's going to have to widen out his stance, choke up on the bat, and really make sure he has pitch recognition before pulling the trigger.
To third might be two. Over to Albies. But safe at first, it's a fielder's choice. Ryan Anderson, the next up for the Marlins. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. And the righty deals. Just off the inside edge. Left field, way back there. And it's off the wall. Safely into second. He's got a double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
So Luke Jackson gets the call. And never an easy situation coming in with runners at second and third. Abisail Garcia, the next up for the Marlins. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
No ball, one strike.
Two outs, two in scoring position. Next offering upstairs. Ball to strike. Misses inside. And a count 2-1.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Here's a 2-1. That clips the corner. Just one out away, trying to close it out. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, this was a total team effort, using six pitchers in this ball game to get the win. Outstanding job of passing the baton, the next guy stepping up and getting it done. You got to give him a lot of credit, because this is not easy to do. We'll see how it affects them over the next couple of days.
6-1 is your final here today. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us.
Big sub woofer bouncing like a trampoline. Glass shake when I roll past the scene. Candy apple paint dripping classic green. Everybody eating, you can ask the team. Fast and mean, speakers bumping, tags is clean. Keep me something, gon' bet. To pump on base, hit like an earthquake. Just hold on, I hit the block and roll on.
Got black 218s, a favorite two short song is in those jeans. Shake it, baby, if you like this song, do it.